Good babes, and welcome back to Black Tea. It's your girl Ebony. Now there are several topics I want to get into, the first topic being none other than Meek Mill being accused by his eldest child's mother of allegedly assaulting her at a party while she was unconscious. Now you guys know Meek Mill has been in the media for nothing but drama lately, and it does seem his baby mother had a few things to get off her chest. Not only did she say that she was unconscious, but she also said that Meek Mill was not present in the child's life. Go ahead and check this out.
And him kicking it, and then I just remember passing out. Like, I don't really remember too much, but I remember something happening to me because I felt pressure inside of me. And then a couple months later, they said I was pregnant. So you guys do the math. If somebody do something to you at a party and you don't remember it, and it was a consensual call.
Non-consensual, and she woke up feeling sore.
Afterwards.
So, your pregnancy, was he there for your pregnancy? Tell us about that. Hold the mic up a little bit closer to you.
Absolutely not. He was nowhere to be found. Once he got me pregnant, he was gone. I never seen him again. He never tried to reach out to me. No, he never cared.
Also, you guys know I am not a Meek Mill fan or advocate. However, I did do some research on this story, and I was able to find that this woman actually had a DNA test done from Meek Mill, and it came out that he was not the father of her child. She has actually been going around for over a year trying to push this story about Meek Mill. I'm not saying that he hasn't done things to women, but I am saying in this case, she is not his baby mother, and she is just looking for some attention. Now, Meek Mill was arguing back and forth with Nicki, and Nicki said the following: "You hurt your own sister and taped it, spit on her and taped it, kicked me in front of your mother and sent her to the hospital. Essing Drake-ish made you feel tough. Move on." Meek Mill saying this: "The only way you can try to kill my career is to say I beat women. Talk about your brother convicted, and you been new and paid for his lawyer. Your little brother touched that little girl too. You know I know. You want me to crash with your boyfriend, and I won't." Now, this entire situation was actually corroborated by DJ Akademiks just last night, where DJ Akademiks came out and said basically Karen Civil, the person that Meek Mill called out, did know of a tape that showed Meek Mill allegedly assaulting a woman. And what did Karen Civil do? Well, she did what Olivia Pope would do. She got rid of the tape. Go ahead and check this out.
People who do, like, Meek got... Apparently somebody told me, yo, Meek on video beating up a chick, bro. The video never came out. Who made it never came out? Karen, bro. What's up with y'all niggas? Y'all talking like, that's what I'm trying to say. All of these niggas, they need somebody like that because they make mistakes. They fuck up. They do human. They do human. So I'm not going to sit here because I watch all of I bring a lot to the forefront, and y'all still look at me like I...
So as you see, there has been story after story corroborating that Meek Mill is very, very toxic when it comes to women. And from what his baby mother is saying, to be quite honest, he's trash. And I really do hope that she's able to get some type of closure and justice. And it also kind of makes Nicki Minaj vindicated, because he tried to paint a picture that he wasn't that type of man. And it seems that he may very well be that, allegedly. Now the next topic I do want to discuss is none other than Kenneth Petty's ex-girlfriend, Redbone No, lying, not only stalking Nicki Minaj and Kenneth Petty, but also coming out after this The Real interview, trying to make it seem like she didn't know about Kenneth Petty's past. Now, you guys know there has been an interview teased with Jennifer Huff, the person that is accusing Nicki and her husband of some not so nice things. Now, Redbone No started with this in Hollywood Unlocked comments. Speak up, queen. She also took to her Instagram story to say this: "I salute anyone that can talk about such a traumatizing situation. It's not easy, whether it happened 20 years ago or yesterday, especially if the bad guy is still trying to bother the victim." She goes on to say this: "First off, I was unaware of that person's background. I would never date a person like that. Let's not get it twisted. I found out when y'all found out." Let me read this one more time. "First off, I was unaware of that person's background. I would never date a person like that. Let's not get it twisted. I found out when y'all found out. Now, the interesting part about this, Redbone, is that this is a bold-faced lie. And I want to take you back to the several tweets of you not only stalking the Petties because you're jealous that Nicki has the man you want, but I also want to correct you in saying it's not good to look for clout and do it while lying. Let's go back to some of the things that you said, proving that you did know about Kenneth Petty's background and that you also felt extremely unhappy that Nicki took your man. I'm getting so many DMs about this anniversary. I could have sworn he left in November. Let me double check. A person asked, you think Nicki and Kenny gonna last? She says, I'm not sure, but I wish them the best. He needed this blessing bad. All he gotta do is stay faithful and don't worry about any of his exes are doing and they will be fine. You go on to say this, Redbone, during your incident. Thanks for everyone's concern and input, but I'm gonna make this clear. That is not my baby father. He was just an ex. His criminal background I did not put out there. That's not my place. Hold up, baby. Hold up. His criminal background I did not put out there. That's not my place. I was hurt in the beginning because it happened so fast, but if they are happy, let them be happy-ish. Stuff happens for a reason. I wish them the best. No, gotta move on too. So baby, which is it? You just said in your last post that you did not know about his criminal background, but here you are in another post saying that you knew about his criminal background and you did not want to put it out there because it wasn't your place. Baby, you gotta pick a struggle. Clout is one hell of a drug. So you just came out here to represent a bold-faced lie against the Petties because you mad she took your man. And I'm gonna tell you why you mad. Let me take you back to something else you said. I have no problem with her, but she is messing with my man that was living with me. How he just wake up and chase behind a rapper? I mean, I know she famous and all. The girls chase rappers all the time. But as a man, my man, I wouldn't expect that at all. He was mine. He's hers now. Nah, I never said that. Someone looked up his record and seen it for theyself. So baby, if you knew that somebody looked up his record and you also had access to that same record and he was living under your roof with your child as a registered SA, then what do you mean you don't know what's going on in the background? I smell clout. I smell a clown. I smell clout chaser. Here you are in several other posts talking about, well, I didn't want to put out his criminal history because I'm not that type of person. Baby, you didn't know about it. You say you would never date a man like that, but he's the same man that was smashing them cheeks while you were in the house with your kid. Allegedly. Oops. I swear, you did all this for clout. You've been talking about Nicki and Kenneth for months. You have been going on interviews saying, oh, well, he's married to a millionaire now. Baby, let it go. He's moved on and gone. He's never coming back. Let it go. But anyways, you guys, I want to hear from you down below. How do you feel about this situation with Meek Mill? This is getting very sticky, especially with the women who are accusing him of a lot of things. And do you think that Nicki Minaj's documentary is what's causing all these people to get exposed? Finally, how do you feel about Red Bono using this opportunity for clout? And how do you feel now knowing that she did indeed know about his criminal history? I look forward to reading your comments. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. I love you guys. To the moon and back, stream Super Bass, and we'll talk down below. Bye, babes.